Hi, this is Matt with Gamer Reaction here with Gary Vinson of the American Classics Arcade Museum. How are you, Gary?
Good, and you?
Very fine. We noticed you have tons of the best in classic gaming here at PAX East. Was it tough shipping all these giant games in?
Actually, we brought them down ourselves, rented two 24-foot box trucks, loaded them up, and drove down here and brought them in on our own.
Good Lord, and it's wonderful. We noticed that you have free tokens in every one of these machines. Do you just want to get people excited or reconnected with classic gaming?
Arcades were a big part of what became, you know, the boom of the home industry and such, but there aren't really any classic arcades that are left where you can go, and that's why in 98 we came up with the idea of starting a museum where people could actually still go in a public venue and play the old school games all the time, because what was happening is collectors were buying them up. They ended up in someone's private collection or in their basement. Unless you knew them, you weren't able to play.
So you had the cherry cabinet artwork locked away in somebody's basement and no one gets to enjoy the Galaga.
Sure. Yeah.
Actually, as a slightly older gentleman than some of these packs here myself, this really takes me back to the classic gaming when you had a handful of quarters and when you were done, your mom picked you up. That's all you had.
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah.
How do you think these classic games that were meant for profit and meant for just last a quarter, how do they stack up against today's home gaming?
Well, the advancements, of course, are like night and day. When you look at the graphics on these games and you look at the graphics on almost all of the home consoles now, they're, obviously the home console graphics are a lot better. But, you know, these still have good, fun gameplay, as you can tell, because this room has been packed since we opened this morning at 10 o'clock.
Yeah, and there's a real charm to it, of amazing. Oh, my God, you got Food Fight. All right, I'm doing that right after. It's cool.
You brought up Food Fight. There's Ms. Pac-Man, Junior Pac-Man, and also Quantum are over there. They were actually designed by General Computer Corporation here in Massachusetts, and they were our guest panel speakers today downstairs in the Cat Theater.
I have to say, from my point of view, these games are 100 times harder than the games you can play at home. When you can only have one quarter's worth of play, there's a lot more on the line than save points and restarts and such like that.
Oh, yeah. When you're paying to play, you're right. Yeah, you can't just, like, mulligan, you know, redo. Yeah.
Over and over.
Yeah. So it's definitely a different experience.
Yeah. Well, we really appreciate you talking to us and coming down this wonderful flashback of the 80s. Best of your luck to you, sir. Thank you for your time.
Great. Thank you.
All right. Off to Food Fight.